Hi everyone, Adesh here from Adesh Model Train. So today we will see how we can configure light as well as server turnout together for the node. So first thing what we will do, we will go to github.com. We'll go to github.com/adesh-model-trains, and inside this git we have a repositories. Once we go into repositories, we will go into project JMRI MQTT Spring Transformer Wireless Ecosystem. This repo is private as of now, but very soon I'm going to make it public. Once we go into this, we can see ESP and Reno solutions. Once we get into that, just make sure that you are always on the main branch. So you here you can see the production V1 branch, develop branch, main backup, main, but make sure you are always on the main branch. And once you get into the main branch, you can see here MQTT server turnout signals. You can just download. So once you get into this, you can see there's a link to download the source code. And for this, what we need is we need NodeMCU as well as Arduino Uno or Mega, whatever you want to use. So now on the main page itself on the GitHub, where we have download link, from where you can download the code for connecting NodeMCU as well as Arduino. What we have to use, we have to use RxTX pin, we have to use common GND, and then we can pass 3-volt power supply from Uno or Mega to the NodeMCU to power up. And then we'll connect PC96 board from Uno or Mega via SCL and SDA line. We will set up the common ground between PC9685 board and Uno or Mega, and then we will supply 5-volt power supply here, and we can pass 5-volt power supply externally to the board 1 and 2. So here if you see in this diagram, here we have connected two boards. So first PC96 board is connected with SD and SCL line here, and then 5-volt power supply and GND, and then it has external 5-volt power supply and GND, and then second board is snapped to the end of the first board, and then the external 5-volt power supply is given to the second board also. And then based on our application and configuration, we will see what board we have to use for light and what board we have to use for configuring the servo. So next thing what we will do is we will just download the source code first. We'll download on the desktop. Here we got downloaded. We got the code now, and we will start updating the code, uploading the code to our Uno and NodeMCU. So let's change the, just select the board type first. Here we'll go into boards, we'll select board type as Arduino Uno. We'll go into port, we'll select the port Arduino Uno, that's correct. We'll just go to config.h. here inside the config.h we will see first thing here, number of turnout ports we need only one, number of light board we need two, total number of boards will be two, this plus this. And then if we go here, range will be 1350 for open and 1650 for closing. So these numbers we got earlier, and we have only one board, so we don't need this. But if you have multiple boards for turnout, servo turnout, you can just keep like this. This is for two, this is for three, and you just like that, you can so on, you can give the number boards there. 1650, and this is the, and we don't need this. So this is like for servo which is mounted on PC96 board on pin number 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, up to 15, 0 to 15 you can configure. So this is what the small change we have to do here, and rest is okay. We can just compile the code. Compilation is done, and let's upload the code. Uploading is done. Here you can see on the total number of PCA board for turnout and signal is 2, total number of board for turnout 1, total number of board for light is 0, board address 40 and 41. So we have configured two board. So board number 40 40 and port number 41 is configured. So we are done with one thing. So now next what we will do, we'll just go and upload the ESP code here. We'll open this sketch. What we have to do, we have to just make sure you have a correct Wi-Fi SID and password, and then this is the IP address of the machine where MQTT is running, and MQTT username and password, and we are listening to this node, this topic, which is because what GMRI will publish, our application will take it, massage the data, and then send back on EMT slash node 1. This is a this configuration we are doing for node 1, and this is a client ID for the node 1. So we are good with this. So we will just connect. You have to select the board type. Instead of Uno, it should be ESP Node MCU, this one, and port number we have to select. Port number should be this port. Let's compile the code. So compilation is done, and now we can upload the code. So it's 61% uploaded. Code uploaded, and if we see the console here, it will try to connect to the Wi-Fi. Is connected, but for MQTT it will not connect because we have not started MQTT. That's fine for us. So we are done with our configuration. We can close this part. So now what we have to do, we have to just do the setup for with the boards, PC9685 boards, server turnouts, and LED signal, and then we will start our MQTT and Spring Transformer application, and then we'll test it from the GMRI Panel Pro. So now you can see here, in this we have done all the setup. What we have done is we have connected the node MCU here with the Uno. So we have used black and white wire which is having TX and RX pin connection. We have yellow and orange pin, which is SD and SCL pin, which is going from Uno to PC9685 board. Here you can see there is a red and brown wire which is coming from this section here. So this carries 3 volt and GND to the node MCU, and there is another one, red and brown, which is going with this, along with this orange and yellow wire, which is taking 5 volt and GND to the first PC9685 board here. And here you can see we have connected SD, SCL, GND and VCC to the first board, and then second board is snapped to the back of the first board here. Here you can see in this board, the breadboard, we are getting external 5 volt here, 5 volt and GND, which we are taking it from breadboard to the second board as well as to the first board. So blue wire is a GND and white wire is a 5 volt, and same here. And from the end of the last board, we are taking 5 volt and GND from this end to taking it to the this another breadboard. So here in this breadboard, you can see from the breadboard, this breadboard, we have a blue cable as well as we have a orange cable, which is taking 5 volt as well as the GND to this relay switch. And this black, if you see here, this black one, which is taking 5 volt to the relay switch here. So So this orange and blue wire is to power up the relay switch, and here these are another orange wire from the second board which is going to the relay switch to control the on off position of the relay switch. And here you can see white and black wire from the end of the relay switch. So black wire is carrying 5 volt and white is carrying, if it is on it will be active. So here you can see LED is configured on this board where we have white wire which is carrying 5 volt, it is connected to resistor, and here we have LED. So where short leg of LED is connected to the breadboard ground line, and long leg of the LED is connected to towards the same line where resistor is connected. So this end here you can see the servo is mounted on the first board here. First board zeroth pin to control this turn off, but we have to verify our configuration. So for that we will start our MQTT, as well as we will start the spring transformer application, and then we'll, with the endpoint, we will validate the configuration, what we have done, is it correct or not. So now first thing what we will do is we'll start the MQTT server. We'll open the terminal, we'll go to desktop, MQTT config, Python start MQTT. So our MQTT has started, and just to listen that, we have in the just earlier tutorial we have seen how we can use the MQTT X client app. So we will use that client app here. So what we have, I explained earlier also, like we have created a connection here, and we have created a subscription for /train/hash and /AMT/node/hash. So anything which is published to any of the nodes will be, we can see it here, and we can just minimize this so we don't need this part as of now. So we'll say connect. So here we can see our MQTT UI client has been connected. Yeah, so this is what MQTT UI client has been connected. So now we are good with this part also. Now what we have to do is we have to start our transformer application. So first thing what we will do, we'll go into Spring Transformer application here, and we'll copy the command, this command. We already downloaded the jar file, so I already explained we can download the jar file here and configuration file from these links getting into this project, Spring JMRA MQTT Data Transformer. So let's open one more tab into the terminal, go to Spring. And before starting the Spring, let's see the configuration what we have in the YAML file, is it correct or not. So we need here node ID 1, node 1 is enable, publishing to MQTT is enabled, REST API publishing is enabled, light count 1 we need, 2 LED signal count 0, 3 LED signal count 0, server turnout I need 1, server turnout, snap turnout I don't need anything now, one turnout board and one light board. So we are good. I'm saving this, and then whatever command we have copied, we just paste that command, and here the application has been started. So we will just get the endpoint to, so if we go into down here, we can, in the page, we can see localhost 8080 /AMT/description/node/id node id. So this node id is something which is for uniquely identify the node. So if we have 10 nodes, we can have 0 or 1 to 10 ids. So here we can see node 1 is enabled, publishing is enabled, REST API is enabled, light count 1, starting from address 10,000, two LED signal count is 0, 3 LED signal count 0, server turnout is 1, starting from 40,000, snap turnout 0, total turnout board is 1, light board is 1, and it will be listening to this GMRI topic, sorry, yeah, MQTT topic here. And then here we can see total number of server turnout board is required 1, total number of snap turnout board is 0, light and signal turnout count is 1 required. So that's why we have configured two boards here, servo number 1 on GMRI address 40001 on board number pin number status. So on board number 0, pin number 0, it will send the throw signal. Board number 0, pin number 0, it will send the close signal. So if we see here, board number 0, pin number 0, it will send throw, and we have to mount our first servo here. So that's how we can validate. And if we see here, light on light number 1, GMRI address 10001, board number, pin number, status. So board number 1, pin number 0, it will send on, and board number 1, pin number 0, it will send off signal. So that's the reason. If you see on board number 1, this is 0, this is 1. So on board number 1, pin number 0, we have connected the relay switch which control the light. Here LED represent the light. So we are good with our configuration. So that's how we can validate that. So now what we have to do is, we don't need this part. We are good with this. We have to just make it little smaller, this section, so that we can listen whatever is published on the this topic. And now we have to start the GMRI, and so we'll start the panel pro. So panel pro is starting, and whatever we have saved earlier in earlier exercise, it will be created here. So let's go to tool, table, lights. Yeah, so we already configure light here on 10001, and turnout, if you see, we have configured on 40001 server turnout. So first we'll start testing the light part. So first thing, we want to ensure that we are on the right network. So we are on Adarsh Model Train, that's the right network, and we should be able to see. Okay, our node MCU is already connected to this, and our transformer application is already connected here. Everything is fine. Let's start the testing. So first thing, we will test the light. So here you can see on GMRI has posted train tracks light 10001 on, and whatever application has sent light, L sent for light 10001, board number 1, pin number 0, on set signal. And if you see here, so what I guess what mistake I have done is, here we have, while configuring the anode type, we should be selecting it as a false. That's the reason it's behaving differently. So if we upload the code again, we have to just remove this RX takes pin first. We have to select the node MCU instead of that Uno, and pin, it's okay. Let's upload this code. Yep, board here, code is uploaded, and we should be able to see. Okay, everything is good. Now we are good. So here, if we make it node type anode, which means we have to make it, if we are using anode type of LED, then we have to make it true. Otherwise, we have to make it for cathode, we have to make it false. And slow move, if you want slow move, make it true. Otherwise, make it false. So we are good with this now, and we have to connect RX deep spin, and we have to restart the, so I'll just take out the USB, and then again I'll put the USB so that it will power up. And here I can see, and I'm on the right network. So that's a serial one. If I just press the refresh, so here you can see connected to MQTT, connected to Wi-Fi. So this is a serial messages on the Arduino ID. So I'll just minimize this also. And here if we see, we have made it off. So now it's on the correct state, it's on. Once I'll make it off, so now it's off. So these are the small things which we have to understand while doing the configuration. If we miss that, we can have these sort of complications, and then we'll be running around like, what's wrong with that. So here you can see on off whatever the messages. And so now let's see the turnout. So we'll go into 40,001, close. So here we can see it was already in the close position earlier, so now it has been thrown. So if it is thrown, train can go in this direction, but if I just make it close, so you can see it's moving from this to that side. And you can do this one, so I'll just make it bigger so you can see this throw. So you can go into the turnout direction, and if I just make it close, it will go straight. And same thing for the light. If I just click on the light, and I'll go and I'll see light, I'll just make it on, light is on. And if I just make the light, light is off. And this is how the simple, and with this UI client, MQTT UI client, it's easy for us to, so number of nodes we are running, like n number of nodes, we can just make it like this: node number 1/hash here, and just make it like this, and you can just delete this one. So this will only track the node number 1. If I just say here, so you can see topic this one on node number 1, off, on. And if we are using like node number 2, just make it like /emt/node/2/hash, and just create like this. So we can create n number of nodes. So let's see what we have here. This is this node. So light train tracks, this should, I guess we have not configured anything on the node number 2. Otherwise we could have seen, if we configure anything, like if we go into signal head, something if we configure, we'll do it later. So once we are done with our basic testing for single node, then we'll try with the multiple node and all, which already I tried. So this is how we can do it for light as well as the servo based turnout using GMRI and MQTT. It's a wireless system. next thing what we will do, we will do the same practice, same exercise with REST API, and then we'll take it to LED signal and 3 LED signal with the configurations. So that's it for this this time, and stay tuned for upcoming content. Please subscribe to my channel and share your thoughts and comment views. Thank you.